Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back. So in today's video, I have my top favorite brown lip products. I just did a video on like my top favorite red for the holidays, and I also did a lip swatch on the Kat Von D liquid lipsticks. And I was thinking, you know, I know sometimes it's kind of hard to find that perfect brown lip for like the fall or like the holidays even. And I kind of dug into my collection and picked out my favorite brown lip products. And I thought it'd be really cool to share these with you guys because I know it's kind of hard to find that perfect brown lip, and I just feel like the ones that I picked out are the perfect brown. Especially for us women of color, I know it's kind of hard to find those perfect lip colors, especially the ones that we don't have to wear a lip liner with. And not only just the browns, even other colors like the mauves, the nudes. So I picked out my favorite brown lip products that I thought were perfect. And I have a couple of lipsticks, I have lip glosses, and I have liquid lipsticks. So I kind of wanted to kind of be similar to the video that I did on my top red lip products. So I have different finishes to share with you guys, and I am excited. I'm actually going to do live lip swatches on this video as well, like I did my other ones. You guys, well, most of you guys already know how I like to do my lip swatch videos. I like to, you know, just talk with you guys, share the product with you guys, and just do the swatch as I'm doing it instead of having like different clips and music going on in the background and stuff like that. And I'm kind of bummed because before I sat down to film this video, I was just digging into my collection and collecting my favorite browns, and I realized I lost my all-time favorite brown lip product, and that is by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and it is the lip gloss in the shade Sepia. Most of you guys know that is my jam. I love that lip gloss. I swear by it. It is my all-time favorite gloss, and I realized I couldn't find it, and I'm thinking I probably lost it during the move. But good thing Sephora is still having that sale, because I'm actually going to stock up on those right now. Well, after I film this video, because I need those in my life, and I can't believe I lost them. I don't even know where they are. Like, I was looking for them from top to bottom in this room, and I could not find them. So anyway, let's go ahead and jump into the lip swatches, and I'm going to kind of share my thoughts on each lip product, because I know some of them may look the same on my lips, but I want to share reasons why I love that lip product. So yeah, if you're interested in seeing all of my top brown lippies, then let's go ahead and jump right in. All right, so we're gonna start off with lipsticks, and it was kind of hard to find like brown, like true brown lipsticks in my collection, because I have ones that are more on the mauve-y side and the reddish side. So I found two of them that I think are perfect brown lippies. Now, one of them, it may look a little red on my lips, but we're gonna go with it. But these are by Minted Cosmetics, and I mentioned this brand a couple of times on my channel already. Now, what I love about this brand is they have all of the perfect nude lip products on their site, and you don't have to wear a lip liner with pretty much all of them, especially for the women of color. If you're looking for that perfect nude lip, y'all have to check out this website. I will have their information down below in my description, but I picked out two of my favorite brown lipsticks from this brand, and one is in the shade Minted Number 5, and the other one is in the shade Foxy Brown. So we're gonna start off with Minted, Minted Number 5. So I can show you guys. These really remind me of the MAC Cosmetics lipsticks. They are so creamy and so moisturizing on the lips. So I'll go ahead and swatch this one so you guys can see what it looks like. All right, so this is Minted Number 5, and what I love about this color is it's a brown, but it kind of has just a hint of mauve to it, but you see more brown than you do mauve, and I think it's just the perfect everyday brown. Even though it's a little bit dark, it's a little vampy, but I still think this is like the perfect everyday brown lip. Again, this is in the shade Minted. And what I also love about this one is it reminds me of my Sepia lip gloss by Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's just in a lipstick version of it. I'll even swatch it on my hand so y'all can see it. It just has like a nice sheen to them. Super pretty. So again, this is in the shade Minted Number 5. Okay, and the next brown lipstick I have by Minted is in the shade Foxy Brown. And this one is more like a reddish brown, but it's deeper than Minted number 5. So I'll swatch this one on my hand so y'all can see this one. Ooh, let me put it down some so it won't break. Well, there is that one. So as you can see, it has more of a red undertone to it, but it's still a beautiful brown lipstick. So let's go ahead and apply this. Alright, so here you have it. As you can see, it has more of a red undertone, but it's still the perfect brown lip, and I just think it is beautiful. This is one of those browns that I probably wouldn't wear every day. I would wear it, you know, like on date night or to a holiday party, just even like going out shopping or anything, but not like an everyday, you know, just an everyday color. I would definitely wear Minted number 5 as an everyday brown, but not this one because, I don't know, I feel like this is just a little too red and too brown to be like a natural everyday brown. But it's still really pretty, and I think it's just the perfect fall, winter, all year round brown lip. So again, this is in the shade Foxy Brown. All right, moving on to the glosses. I only have 3 glosses to share, minus the Sepia lip gloss, which I wish I still had in my collection, but y'all know. Well, if you haven't seen Sepia, go to Sephora and swatch it. You're gonna love it. You are gonna love it. So I do plan on stocking up on those after I get done filming this video because the Sephora sale is still going on. So I wanna go ahead and stock up on those because I run through those like crazy. But we're gonna swatch one by CoverGirl, and this is the melting pout gel liquid lipstick, and this is in the shade Celebrity. Now the reason why I love this one is because it's very, very nice on the lips. It feels like a gel. Like, it says it's a gel liquid lipstick, which it truly is. It feels like a gel. It's not sticky. It's very comfortable on the lips, and it's super, super pigmented. So yeah, this is definitely one of my top drugstore lip products. Really good, you guys. If you have not tried these, check them out. They have a wide variety of colors. This is just the one that really just stood out to me because it's one of those that I could wear every day and not have to, you know, pair it with a different outfit. It's just a color that works for an everyday lip. I did a full review on this lip product in the past, so if you haven't seen it, I'll have a little link down below so you guys can check it out. So let's go ahead and swatch this one. This has like a little sponge applicator. You just squeeze it and the product comes out on the sponge, which I think is really cool. All right, so this is what this one looks like. It's kind of similar to the very first lipstick I swatched, which is in the shade Minted number 5. And I'll go ahead and swatch it on my hand. I'm kind of getting my shirt dirty, so let me pull my sleeve up. But I'll go ahead and swatch it so y'all can see the comparison. So the very first shade, right there. Well, it's a little bit lighter actually. I don't know if you guys can see that on camera, but it's a little bit lighter than Minted number 5, and it's kind of faded off because I hid it on my shirt, but that's okay. So yeah, this is in the shade Celebrity, and again, it's by CoverGirl, and it's their new melting pout gel liquid lipstick. So really love this one. This is also one that I would wear as an everyday color because it's not too dark and it is just the perfect natural brown lip. It has a little bit of mauve to it, but it's more brown and gray tone than it is like a mauve color. And I definitely don't have to pair a lip liner with this one as well, which is also a plus. So again, this is in the shade Celebrity. All right, moving on to one of my top favorites, which is the Melted Latex Liquid Lipstick by Too Faced, and this is in the shade Strange Love. So this is more of a lighter brown, kind of like a grayish tone brown, and this is also one of the ones that I mentioned in, well, not this shade, but this is one of the lip products that I mentioned in my top 7 red lipsticks for the holidays. I had the red one in this same formula, and I just love the Melted Latex. They are so pigmented. They're a little sticky though, so let me go ahead and show you guys what this one looks like on the lips. Yeah, so they're a little sticky. If you don't like sticky glosses, you're not gonna like these, but they're super pigmented. As you can see, this one has more of a gray undertone. It's still a really pretty brown, but you have more gray to it. So if you don't like your grayish brown lip products, you may not like this one, but I still think this is a really, really pretty brown, like a fall brown lip, even though it does have that little gray undertone to it, but it's like a cool tone lip product. So love, love, love these. I love how these stay on the lips. I know with some lip glosses, and I've mentioned this quite a few times on my channel, and I feel like I'm repeating myself, but if you have not, you know, heard my thoughts on the melted latex lipsticks, I'll go ahead and let you guys know the reason why I love them. And that is because they literally stay on the lips. With some glosses, they kind of get around the edges of your lips, especially throughout the day when you're wearing them. They kind of fade through on the edges of your lips, and these, they stay in place and they do not bleed on my teeth. So as I'm talking, I don't have to worry about like constantly licking my teeth, because I know these are not gonna get on the teeth. I don't know, I guess it's because they're just, because they're sticky, I don't know, but I've never experienced these coming off on my teeth as I'm talking, and I just love how they stay on the lips. They're very, very pigmented, and they are super, super shiny. And let me swatch it on my hand so y'all can see them compared, this one compared to the other one swatched. So there's that one. And again, it is in the shade Strange Love. So I have the NARS Velvet Lip Glaze. This is in the shade Area. Now these are, they're not a gloss, but they're not like a liquid lipstick. They're kind of like in between. They have that velvet finish. So again, this is in the shade Area, and this is the perfect dark brown lip product. Let me show you guys how it looks. It is so dark and vampy, but I feel like it's the perfect chocolate brown lip. All right, so this is what Area looks like. As you can see, it is super dark. It's kind of like the darkest brown that I'm gonna be showing you guys today, but it is beautiful. I love a dark vampy lip, especially around the holidays or just for the fall time period. But this is such a beautiful brown. If you like your deep dark browns and you don't like that matte look or that super glossy look, this is the perfect lip product, because it's very it's not glossy glossy. When you press your lips together, it kind of loses that extra shine. So these are like a velvet finish, so they're not like a lip gloss and they're not like a liquid lipstick. They're just kind of in between, and they're very comfortable on the lips, very smooth, not sticky at all. And what I've noticed about the NARS Velvet Lip Gloss is they kind of stain your lips just a little bit, so you don't have to worry about retouching up as much as you would think, because it kind of like dries onto the lips kind of like a stain, but it still has that nice sheen to it. It's not too sheeny though. That's not even a word. It's not too sheen to where it looks too glossy, but I don't know, they're just so comfortable on the lips. It kind of wears like a lipstick, but it's a lip glide and it's velvet, so I don't know. I don't know how to explain it, but I still love the product and I love the color. So again, this is in the shade Area. All right, moving on to the liquid lipsticks, and I only have two to share with you guys, because I don't really have many brown liquid lipsticks, but these two were my favorites out of my collection. So the first one I want to share is by Kylie Cosmetics, and this is the True Brown K liquid lipstick. And this is the lip product that I wore all the time last year around this time in my videos. This is actually my favorite lip product from all of the lip products that she's come out with. This one is hands down my favorite one. And again, this is in the shade True Brown K. I will swatch this one right here. So it's kind of similar to the NARS one, but it has a little more chocolate. It's a little more brown than the NARS Velvet Lip Glide. So let me swatch this one. All right, so this is True Brown K. It is a true matte liquid lipstick, and it dries down matte. When you're applying it, it feels really creamy. It feels like you're not wearing anything on the lips. And I just think it is that perfect brown matte liquid lip. So yes, love it, love it, love it. Okay, last but not least, I have a lip product from Ofra Cosmetics, and this is their liquid lipstick in the shade Brooklyn. Now, Brooklyn is a little bit similar to True Brown K, but I think it's a little bit deeper than True Brown K. So let me swatch this one on my hand so y'all can see them side by side. Yeah, so it's a little deeper. I know you guys probably don't even see the difference, but up close, it's a little deeper than True Brown K. So I'll go ahead and swatch this one. All right, so this is Brooklyn by Ofra Cosmetics. Does look very similar to the True Brown K liquid lipstick. I just feel like it's a little bit darker, just a hint bit darker than the True Brown K liquid lipstick. They actually have like a really nice moussey texture when you're applying it on the lips, and they don't crack. So I know with some liquid lipsticks throughout the day, you can kind of see the cracking around your lips, but these do not. Super comfortable, super pigmented. But yeah, I think those are all of my favorite browns that I have in my collection. I tried to pull the ones that I didn't have to pair with another lip product, like another, you know, like a lip liner or anything like that. So these are my most favorite ones that are comfortable on the lips, that are super pigmented, and that are also long lasting. I don't really have like drugstore brown lipstick, like a true brown drugstore lipstick. So if you guys have any suggestions on ones that I should try out, let me know down in the comments. I know in my recent video when I did my top seven red lipstick for the holidays, a lot of you guys were like, why have not tried out the Colored Rain cherry blossom lipstick? And I was like, oh my god, I must have been sleeping because I did not know anything about that lipstick. So I want to know you guys' suggestions if you have any of them. Ones that are from the drugstore, I would love to try out different drugstore lipsticks, either lipsticks, liquid lipsticks, or lip glosses. If there are any brown ones, because I love my brown lip products, let me know down in the comments so I can check them out and also try them out. So yeah, I think those are all the ones that I had to share with you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you thumbs it up if you did, and also if you're not subscribed, make sure you subscribe so that way you guys will never miss out on anything that I upload. So yeah, I think that is everything I have for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.